Hey, in this video, we are going to look at the Askling Hamstring Strain Rehab Program. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. The hamstrings are comprised of the biceps femoris that has two heads, a short and a long one, the semitendinosus and the semimembranosus muscle. The hamstring strain is one of the most prevalent sports injuries, and lots of efforts are made to reduce their incidence. Askling et al. Observed two main mechanisms of injury in elite soccer players, which were either stretching type, such as during glide tackle, or high kick, and sprinting type injuries occurring during high-speed running. What they found was that the stretching type injuries affected mostly the semimembranosus, and the sprinting type injury, the long head of the biceps femoris. When they compared their rehab protocol focusing on load during lengthening, it appeared superior to conventional protocols. So let's dive into the exercises.
The first exercise is the extender. Hold and stabilize the thigh of the injured leg with the hip flexed approximately 90 degrees. Then perform slow knee extensions to a point just before pain is felt. The exercise should be done twice every day for 3 sets with 12 repetitions. The second exercise is called the diver. Stand on the injured leg with the knee slightly flexed. Then perform a dive forward by flexing at the hip joint and extend the arms forward. The swinging leg can be bent to approximately 90 degrees of knee flexion. Start slow in the beginning and increase speed gradually. This exercise should be done once every other day for 3 sets of 6 repetitions. The third exercise is called the glider. Start from a position with upright trunk. Hold on to a support rail and stand with the legs slightly split. Put the body weight on the heel of the injured knee, in this case the left, with approximately 10 to 20 degrees of knee flexion. The motion is started by gliding backward on the other leg and stopped before pain is reached. The movement back to the starting position should be performed by the help of both arms, not using the injured leg. Progression is achieved by increasing the gliding distance and performing the exercise faster. Do this exercise once every third day for 3 sets of 4 repetitions.
Alright, thanks for watching this video on the Askling protocol. If you liked it and found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel if you haven't. And also be sure to check out our other exercise videos in the playlist on the left. As always, this was Andreas for Physiotutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.